In this video, we're going to look at the process of how to get started with the SAP HANA Cloud trial. Now, this new trial is part of the SAP Cloud Platform trial. So we'll start there by just doing a general setup of a new account in the SAP Cloud Platform trial. Now, you might already have an account, in which case these first couple steps won't be necessary for you, but I'm starting from scratch as though I've never used the SAP Cloud Platform or HANA Cloud trial. And I'll go ahead and create a new account, and we'll give that just a moment to do its creation process. And there we are, the trial account is created. We'll go ahead and navigate into it. Let's go into the sub-account. I actually want to check the assignments this level, that way I can make sure that they are assigned properly to my sub-account. And what we should see here is we have an SAP HANA Cloud, and we have an SAP HANA Schemas and HDI Containers. Now, you might still see this SAP HANA Schemas and HDI Containers trial. Now, don't be confused by that and use that accidentally. That'll actually point the older HANA as a service trial. If you want to use HANA Cloud, we need to use the SAP HANA Cloud service to create an instance of the database itself, and then we can use the SAP HANA Schemas and HDI Containers to create an instance of a container or a schema inside the HANA Cloud, not this one here. Now, I just created a new account, therefore I had these entitlements added automatically, and anyone who creates a new account would get that. If you have an existing account, you may have to go in and do the configure entitlements and then add service plans. And we can just come here and we can search for HANA, in which case you would select the SAP HANA Cloud and then check the boxes to add those plans to your account, and then come here and do the same thing with the SAP HANA Schemas and HDI Containers to add those as well. Like I said, that's if you already have an existing trial. Mine was brand new, so it added it to me automatically, but if you don't find those here in your entitlements, this is the process that you can use to add them. In fact, I know what I'm going to do now. I'm going to come here and I'm actually going to delete the entitlements for this other trial one, just so I don't accidentally use it or confuse myself later. And we'll go ahead and save that process, and I should be pretty well set up there. Now, what we want to do is we want to go into our spaces. Here is our development space, and once I'm in my space for my trial account, you'll see this option over here on the left-hand menu for SAP HANA Cloud, and we can simply come here, and no, I don't have any instances, but I can say create instance, and it's going to ask me some things. What do I want to name the instance? HANA Cloud trial. The name's private to me, and you can only have one in a trial account, so the name probably doesn't mean a whole lot there. Set an initial administrator password, my HANA Cloud trial. That looks good. Step two. There's really no sizing that you can do on the trial either. You're locked in to a minimal size, but it's more than enough to certainly play around with, do education on. And step three, the data lake. I'm not actually going to enable the data lake. This is an additional optional feature that for now I'm not going to utilize. So I'll skip over that step and leave it turned off. Leave the resources for anybody else who might want to do that. And I'm going to go ahead and change the IP address settings here to allow all IP addresses. Now, this being a development trial system, I'm not that concerned about somebody accessing it from the outside. And I want to be able to develop from my local machine and maybe run SQL statements in an external tool that connects remotely to the HANA system. Ideally, in a productive setting, I would probably Set up IP address ranges so that, I'm safely saying, oh, only IP addresses from my company, my laptop, whatever, can access it. But, since this is a private trial and I'm just playing around here, I'm just going to go ahead and use the allow all IP addresses. I will say create instance. And the process will start. You see here it's creating, and this would take a couple minutes, anywhere. I've seen it take, 2-3 minutes, 5 minutes, depending on the load on the system. Not a terribly long amount of time, but just a little bit. So I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll pause the video and we'll come back when it's finished. And here we are a couple minutes later. Our system is finished being created. It is up and running. Now, one thing you might note with the trial is that overnight, when you haven't been using it, it might stop, go to sleep, basically. None of your data is lost. So when you come back in the morning, the status may not be running. It may be stopped, and then instead of the stop button, you'd have a start button, which you would then press to restart the system each day. A small trade-off for getting a free trial, right? It's to make sure that we don't have a lot of resources going unused, but still costing money, right? From here, from the SAP HANA Cloud instances, we can go directly into the HANA cockpit if we want to do administration. So if I click that, then it will open the HANA cockpit in another tab. It's going to ask me, now remember your username, it's not system, it's DB admin. That's the power user here. Admin, and then whatever password you set during the creation process. There we are. And I'm logged in. I can do administration, monitoring. From here I can go to the SQL console. So all the good stuff you need, because this is a whole HANA system for you as part of the trial. Private to you. You aren't sharing it with anyone else. It isn't like some of the trials in the past where we gave you just a schema or just an HDI container on a shared instance. We're really giving you an entire private instance of HANA for you to use. And the other menu option here is, yes, you can go directly into the HANA Database Explorer. Give that a moment to start up. I have some previous content in my Database Explorer from other systems and things that I've done, but it will load this particular system here in just a second. There we are. There's my HANA Cloud trial. And if I look in the catalog, not a whole lot in here yet since it's largely an empty system to begin with. If we look at all schemas, you'll see some system schemas, but not a lot of content. Of course, at this point, I could go ahead and start loading some content. For instance, I might come here and do import catalog objects. And on my local computer, I've got an export of sflight. So just come here, sflight. And it will now upload that to the server. And we can go ahead and import. And this will take a second or two as well, depending upon network connection speeds and things like that. And our import is done. If I were to come here to schemas, for instance, and we now have an sflight schema, or for instance, I can come here to tables, and we're seeing the sflight table definition. And we can look at the data as well. So there, we've got a little data in our system that we can play around with as well. That's the basics of getting started here with the Database Explorer and the HANA cockpit. But now we want to do development. So let's see how we can get started doing some of our own custom development.